German forces invaded Poland. The Nazi regime has classified Poles as subhumans and had adopted a policy committed to the destruction and deportation of all Polish citizens. On the eve of the invasion, Hitler held a meeting with his high officials.
I have placed my death head formations in readiness with orders to send to death, mercilessly and without compassion, men, women, and children of Polish derivation and language. Only thus shall we gain living space that we need.
During the invasion, Hitler deployed special action squads that concentrated on eliminating any form of Polish resistance. In addition to his genocidal policy, which had targeted all of Poland's 3.3 million Jews, he required that any Polish citizen considered capable of emerging as a leader in resisting the German occupation of Poland also be eliminated. This group of condemned Poles became known as the Polish intelligentsia and was comprised largely of wealthy landowners, government officials, university professors, doctors, teachers, priests, and journalists.
Poles may have only one master. Two masters cannot exist side by side, and this is why all members of the Polish intelligentsia must be killed.
Tens of thousands of intelligentsia were murdered in mass executions or sent to prisons or concentration camps. Another Nazi policy aimed at weakening resistance efforts was that of separating family members from one another. Separation instilled fear and effectively demoralized Poles, weakening their resolve to resist. Between 1939 and 1945, at least 1.5 million Polish citizens were separated from their families and transported to the Reich to perform forced labor. Many were teenage boys and girls. It was 1942 and I was 18 years old. The Nazis had come to our home to take me away, but I was not there. When I returned home, my mother quickly dressed me as an old woman and took me to the country where she hid me in the attic of a family. I did not even know. 3 days later, my mother received an official letter from the mayor of our town. It stated that if I did not appear, my family would be evacuated from the town and shot. My mother came to where I was hiding and showed me the letter, begging me not to go, but I knew what I must do. There were 19 other teenage girls from town on the military bus that took us to a nearby camp where we were examined by German doctors. Once we were declared healthy, SS soldiers escorted us to a waiting train and crammed us into a cattle car. Then with clanging joy, the train began to roll us away from all that we loved dearly to our new destination, Germany.
Thank you. Christ